How's it guys? This is Gus, the African plant hunter. I am in Nuremberg in Germany at an organic food trade show, and I am showing the amazing African baobab fruit. And this is part one in a three-part series where I'm explaining some of the health properties of the baobab fruit. And I'm going to focus in this one on the glycemic response and the role that baobab plays in moderating that. Now, baobab fruit powder is nearly 50% fiber, and that fiber is exactly evenly balanced between soluble and insoluble fiber. Along with the fiber, there are also some what they call polyphenols, polyphenolic compounds, and both the fiber and the polyphenolic compounds have a role in moderating the glycemic response. How do we know that? Well, in 2013, a research institute at Oxford Brookes University in the UK undertook research. What they did was they added baobab to two different types of product to see products that they knew would provoke a very quick glycemic response, and they added them to see if the presence of baobab would moderate that response. So the first product was white bread. So they made some white bread rolls. Now, as soon as you eat a bread roll, because it's a processed carbohydrate, you have a very quick glycemic response, something of a kind of a spike. The problem with that is that you produce a lot of glucose, more glucose than your body needs at the time, so it gets converted to glycogen, and then if it's not used for energy, eventually it will get converted to fat. So when you have a processed carbohydrate that provokes this instant kind of glycemic spike, it ultimately will lead you to putting on weight and eventually to potentially developing type 2 diabetes. So obviously it's something that you want to try and avoid if possible. Now, in this research at Oxford Brookes University, they added a little bit of baobab powder in to the baked bread, and they then tested a bunch of volunteers, some of whom had the baobab and some of whom didn't, ate the white bread, measured the glycemic response, and sure enough, they saw that the glycemic response was very, very much moderated by the presence of baobab in the bread rolls. They did the same thing with liquid. So they made a liquid which was consumed and again provoked quite a high glycemic response, and then when they added baobab into it, it was a much more moderated response. So the conclusion is, and there's a lot more research to be done on this, but the conclusion is that the fiber and the polyphenols in baobab do help to moderate the glycemic response, which is very, very, very helpful for people who perhaps are a little bit prone to the conditions that might lead to diabetes or at high risk, and people who are trying to manage their glycemic response and the associated insulin response. So that is the first of the fantastic, miraculous health properties of baobab. I'm Gus, the African plant hunter. If we haven't met before, this is what I like to do. Little stories about African plants, African trees. I'm here in Germany, very far from Africa, selling the magnificent African baobab fruit for its health properties. I do hope to see you again. Plenty more on my YouTube channel, Facebook, Instagram, africanplanthunter.com. I will see you later. Bye.